I think the practice of true journalism in Iran is a very highly political act, regardless of the subject matter. Every journalist who wishes to work in Iran and who is trying to perpetuate the truth on any level having to do with anything is a heroic figure.
Mohammed Sadegh Kaboudvand, maybe a name familiar to some, maybe not to others. He's currently in Evin prison. He was a peaceful activist who founded this group, the RMMK, in April 2005, and its stated mission is to promote the Universal Declaration of Human Rights, the Vienna Declaration, and other international covenants. And for that, he was arrested in 2007 and sentenced to 11 years of imprisonment. Officially, he was accused of endangering national security, spreading propaganda against the Iranian regime by circulating news, opposing the Islamic Penal Code by openly criticizing penalties such as stoning and hanging, and he was also charged with his support of political prisoners.
Journalist like Shiva Nazar Ahari is considered a political prisoner, and after the fraudulent 2009 elections was held for many, many months in solitary confinement, charged with having reported and defended people who were political prisoners in Iran for years. Shiva herself was imprisoned and charged with Harb, or combating God.
I think any government that jails journalists is not only against human rights and freedom of the press, but is also against democracy, because journalists are so important in communicating the story of the lives of everyday people, as well as keeping an eye on institutions and governmental activities.
There is no such a thing as press freedom in Iran, because newspapers are very strictly under watch. First of all, you have to give permission to start any kind of media publication, and then you have to be very careful about what you say in order to continue that publication. Self-censorship is something that you grew up with that in a professional atmosphere, because you know, for example, this word or this sentence or this opinion you can't express. If you do, the newspaper will be shut down.
Many Iranians, particularly in urban centers, use the internet. There's a high rate of internet usage, and a lot of, you know, I'd say a lot of forms of expression in journalism have moved from print form to those online spaces. However, it's particularly in recent months, there's been, you know, incredible pressure from governmental authorities to shut down, filter and censor many of those websites, you know, monitor personal Twitter and Facebook accounts, and it's becoming increasingly difficult for there to be that open space in Iran as well.
Totalitarian leaders instinctively know how powerful the ideas are, how important books are in shaping the minds of the people, how the free flow of information is shaping general ideas of an entire population, is expressing the hopes and aspirations of the public. And therefore, maybe the totalitarian regimes know and instinctively understand the importance of books, ideas, and literature.
They have punishments that include, in some cases, 74 lashes, for instance, for stirring up unease among the citizenry. So there are scores of journalists who are locked up. They also are exporting this know-how and technology to other countries. So for instance, they've been a big assistance to Syria in exporting both technology and know-how to clamp down on dissent and contrary voices, and it's part of what's allowing the Syrian government to stay in power. And you can just expect that that other repressive regimes will be in the market for having this information coming from Iran.
You can't really control what people are thinking. You can control what they're maybe saying in public, but you can't stop them from thinking what they're thinking. And I think that that will lead, hopefully, to a more open Iran, you know, down the road.
Those who are suffering as a result of it in prison today are not only journalists who are in prison, but certainly some of the greatest figures in Iranian history ever. And I think those are precisely the figures that someday, when Iran becomes democratic, we will probably name streets after them or build statues in their memory.